it's going to be down to David Seaman to save the day. And Templemars to take. And it's 1-1. Roll it in.
That really didn't calm everyone down.
But everybody made comparisons with 30 years before.
Yeah, Uruguay.
And I'll tell you what, England-Switzerland was a great deal better than England-Uruguay, which was a terrible game.
And the European Championship opens with a draw.
We're going to get 3 points against Scotland and then try and get something against Holland as well, to be sure, getting through, so it's going to be tough. You're going to have to play better than that.
A little bit disappointed, but we look forward to the Scotland game. We've got a week to prepare for it. But don't write us off.
I just don't know whether we expect too much from the manager and the quality of players that we have.
Have a right to kind of expect England to beat Switzerland at Wembley.
Inventive, creative, on the ball, he's England's best player. An open play, if anybody's going to make it happen, is going to be Paul Gascoigne. But after 50 minutes, he disappeared, and England as an attacking force disappeared as well.
We're on our way to see Gazza. He's doing a Q&A in Newcastle. He does 20 or 30 a year now, which is great for him. He's got to have an income. People, I think, have badly advised him, took advantage of him, because he's such a genuine and open and honest guy. His dream was to be a footballer. It was like mine. He was fortunate enough to make it as a footballer because of his talent. He left here the North East and went down to London, which many say was the downfall of him. If he had gone to Manchester with Fergie, then it might have been slightly different, and I probably agree with that. I know he's had a bit of a tough time over the last few years. When you look at some people, you're hoping the penny might drop. And I hope daily, and I pray daily, that I don't wake up hear that the worst has happened to Gazza, because the world would be a sadder place without him.
Did you miss football?
Oh, badly.
You loved it, didn't you?
Definitely. Oh, you know, I really miss it badly, even today. You know, I just still wish I was playing. I find it really hard to sometimes watch
games.
But
you're games. Good, though. You're good. You're looking good.
Yeah, not too bad. Yeah. It took us 20 years, like, but...
What's your memories of Hong Kong?
Just
before 96.
I can't remember. And all I know is I went on some chair for a filling. My tooth was slack at the back.
The dentist chair.
Yeah, the dentist chair. Obviously, it was my birthday as well that time, and I know that. So, and I'm talking about celebrating your birthday.
Terry Venables, happy to face autograph hunters. A welcome change from fending off a week of constant questions, yet again on fitness, nightclubs and alcohol.
The public pick up the paper and they're going to believe all they're reading, that and we're made out to have had a three-week party here.
A few beers, good weekend. Can't be it.
I think the Scots felt this was their great chance. They thought they could come to Wembley and really put up a show.
Paul Gascoigne is the talk of the town. What will you be saying to him before this match?
Well, I've already spoken to him. I just want him to relax and get his head around the game. I mean, he's been doing that all week.
You've always had a special bond with him, haven't you?
Yeah, he's just beyond anything you would expect from his football, from his cheek, from his audacity, from anything he could do. I mean, he was a brilliant player.
That night before the game in Scotland, it was 10 o'clock and I couldn't sleep, and I knocked on his door and he went, "What do you want?"
Yeah.
I went, "I'm worried." And he went, "Sit down." And I went, "Yeah." He said, "What are you worried about?" And I went, "I don't know if you're going to pick us or not." He said, "I'm not."
Yeah.
So I've got tears in my eyes, right? I'm saying, "Please, I promise I'll play well."
Yeah.
And he left the score for about 45 minutes, and now it's like 10:15. He went, "Of course you're playing, now get to bed and sleep."
I think it's a chance for this English team to show the nation that last Saturday was a one-off.
England have had their problems. Have they got together as a group and said, "Right, they've slated us, lads, let's go out and show them"?
We'd not played Scotland for ages, you know, so it was, there was that pressure. Then there's the pressure that we actually needed to win.
Months of anticipation building up to this moment as Scotland in blue start the match.
Shouldn't be far away. Shearer's going one
Cheeky.
Up here.
Was a good guy.